Hello lovely people, welcome back to my channel. My name is Chandrika. Today we would be doing this blue cut crease with glitter eye makeup, and I will be using Plume eyeshadow brushes to do this makeup. So let's get into the tutorial. First, I'm going to take the P11 brush from the Plume eyebrush set. This is a flat concealer brush. We will be using this to cut our crease also. So first, I'm going to take concealer on the back of my hand and pick the product only by the tip of this concealer brush and start applying this on the upper part of my eyelid. We are going to apply the product only the upper part of our eyelid because we will be cutting the crease, and let's not load up with lot of product. As you can see, the brush is very flexible. I'm really liking this. I'm able to shape my brows also. Make sure you use the product only on the upper part of your eyelid. Next, I'm going to take this eyeshadow guard. This will help me to achieve a sharp wing effortlessly, and also we are going to be using a lot of eyeshadow and glitter, so this will help us with the fallout also. You can get this from Amazon. As you can see, I have not set the base, it's still wet. I'm going to take the PO8 brush. This is a small fluffy brush, it's a pencil type brush. It's easy to pick up the product and pack the eyeshadow on the lid. I'm going to pick up this dark blue shade. As you can see, it has picked up enough eyeshadow. I'm going to set this on the wet base. We are going to create a half moon shape on our upper crease part. So take your time. Everybody has a different eye shape, so we'll take our time and then start packing the eyeshadow. You can also look straight in the mirror and know your eye shape. So we will pack the eyeshadow parallel to our upper eye line. As you can see, I have a crease and I'm packing the eyeshadow on the upper side of my crease, not on my crease, but on the upper side of my crease. I'm going to explain everything in detail so that you all understand. I know in my previous tutorials I have rushed a bit, but here I'm going to take time and I'm going to explain every step. So coming back to the tutorial, we are packing the eyeshadow on the wet base. Do not blend it yet. Now you can understand why I asked you not to set, because you see how our concealer has picked up the pigment. You see that? If we use a setting powder, then our eyelid wouldn't have picked up so much pigment. We had to layer and layer. So this is the trick which I've picked up lately. Look at that beautiful pigment. Now I'm going to take P24 and I'll slowly start buffing the eyeshadow, the outer part of the eyeshadow. I'm showing you everything in detail. So I'm still not rubbing it, I'm just patting it so that you know the eyeshadow slowly spreads, and then I'm going to blend it. To achieve a beautiful eye look, you need patience, you need lot of time. So I suggest you to, you know, this is lockdown, so when you have free time, just sit in front of the mirror, play with colors, and with patience start blending. You will ace this. Next, I will take the P12 brush. This is a long pencil brush, and take this cream shadow and apply it near my brow bone and all over the upper lid part where we have not packed the blue shadow. Here we are setting the concealer now. Now I'm going to show you my cut crease trick. I'm going to take an earbud and flatten it out with my finger, and you can take a micellar water. Here I prefer makeup remover cream. I'm going to pick the makeup remover cream with my earbud and then start cleaning my lid. I generally look straight into the mirror and then start doing my cut crease. I'm going to clean the eyeshadow. I'm going to show you how I look into the mirror. So now you can have an idea. Next, I'm going to remove all the eyeshadow once I do the cut crease. I'll then take the dry end of the earbud and then clear all that makeup cream. Next, I'm going to take the same P11 concealer brush which we have used initially to prime our eyelids. This is a flat concealer brush. I'm flattening this out more. So now you see how razor sharp this is. I'm going to take concealer in the back of my hand and pick up with the tip of the brush, and then slowly I'm going to start filling the crease. It's always better if you apply the product below and then go on to shape it up. I really love this brush, guys. You have to go and get this if you want to shape your brows or do a cut crease, because this is very flexible. It has very soft bristles and it bends onto whatever shape you want it. So once I have achieved a cut crease shape, I'm going to pat on with more concealer. Next, I'm going to take the same P8 brush which we have used to pack the eyeshadow. I don't have any shadow on it. With whatever is left, I'm going to blend this in so that we have a nice faded look inside. Next, I'm going to take P18. This is a flat brush, and then I'm going to pick up this beautiful blue sparkly eyeshadow, and then I'm going to spray a setting spray, or you can spray water also, and then I'm going to pat this onto my eyelid where we have done the cut crease. Look how beautiful that is looking, guys. Look at those tiny sparkles. I have also mentioned all the product details down in the description box below. Please do check it out. I'm leaving a tiny part of my inner corner. You will see why. Also, I'm using the same brushes back and forth. Looks like I'm using a lot of brushes, but no, that's why I always am mentioning the brush coats before I'm showing you the eyeshadows. I'm taking the same P12 long pencil brush and picking up this brown shadow and starting to wing out. This will give us a beautiful lifted winged eye look. Take your time while blending this. I'm going to take that small blue eyeshadow brush and blend both the brown and blue. By blending so, you're getting this beautiful smoky eye effect. Next, I'm going to take this beautiful liquid glitter champagne shadow with P13 eye brush. I'm going to pick up this liquid glitter metallic shadow. As you can see, this is a beautiful triangle shaped brush apt for applying shadows in your inner corner and brow bone. Now I'm slowly applying this onto my inner corner. Take your time and figure out till where you want your glitter to be. To me, I like to have my glitter in the inner 1/4 of my eye. Next, I will take this gel liner and with P14 eyeliner brush. This is an angled eyeliner brush. This is very good eyeliner brush because it will reach every corner of your lash line. We are going to apply this gel liner very close to our lash line in order to cover our false eyelash band. Now I will take a wet tissue and clean out all the fallout and remove my eyeshadow guard. Now you can see how effortlessly we have achieved that sharp wing eye look. Now I'm going to take the other sticky side and remove all the glitter. I will now apply mascara and pop on some false eyelashes. Talk to you about Bloom sponges. These are makeup sponges, very affordable sponges. I've been using them since a year and I really love them. And you can see they are small in size, but once you wet them in water, they come up to double size. This is a teardrop shape, so this will easily reach both any corner of your under eyes and all over your face. This round shape is apt for applying foundation, dabbing foundation or any product on your face, and the pointed shape, the peak shape, is apt to reach any corner around your eyes. I have already primed and applied concealer. Now let's see how this wet sponge is going to perform. I'm going to dab it. Don't drag the product, dab it. I like the way this is performing. It's diffusing the product very nicely into my skin. I'm going to do the same on the outer side, outer area of my eye also. By applying concealer like this, you can get a very easy eye lift look effortlessly. You can see how my eye has lifted up instantly. Always dab the product, guys. Do not drag it. Always dab, dab, dab. Next, I'm going to take this microfiber plume sponge used for contour and baking. I'm going to take some translucent powder. I have already contoured my nose, so I'll show you. Look how beautifully that angle is giving me an axis to shape both my nose as well as my under eye. We have to apply some eyeshadow on our lower lash line also. That's why I'm going to apply some translucent powder. I'm not baking because I don't like to bake my under eyes. So I'm going to take this PO8, the same brush we used initially. I'm going to take the same dark blue eyeshadow and slowly start applying the dark blue eyeshadow in the inner third of my lower lash line. And with whatever is left on my P14 eyeliner brush, I'm going to extend the wing onto my inner side of my lower lash line. And then using the same long pencil P12 brush, I'm going to blend everything together. Now I will take this white kajal and apply it into my inner lash line. Now you can see how my eye has opened up. I will dust off all the translucent powder and apply mascara into my lower lash line. I wanted to save my best tip for the last. So, in order to define and highlight your inner crease, what you have to do is take this small pencil brush and take the same dark shadow and start defining your inner crease line also. So you see how beautiful that is looking. Now the glitter is even more highlighted. Overall, I'm in love with these eye brushes. They are on sale on their website and you can buy them individually also. I'm going to link everything down below in the description box. And I hope I've taught you everything to my best knowledge. And I will see you in my next tutorial. Bye guys. Keep supporting me. Subscribe to my channel. Love you. Bye bye.